As you know, it was about 3 weeks into the program and I was making tremendous progress and I felt great. And this is where I start crying.
All right, you guys are about to watch right now a testimonial video of one of my clients who just graduated from the program. And I'm leaving it uncut. I'm leaving the full video up just because of how deep we went. Sometimes we talked about the program, sometimes we didn't. It's just uncut conversation, human to human. And if you have a short attention span and you want constant dopamine, this is not for you. But if you want to understand where she was and the type of stuff she had to go through, Cari, type of stuff Cari had to go through along this program, I'd watch this. All right, so here's the video and I'll speak to you soon. Peace. Hello, welcome everyone. I hope you're doing amazing. Right now, I'm going to be interviewing a client of mine who just graduated from the Overcoming Stuttering Academy. She's on week 10, just graduated. I'm going to ask her some questions, see where she's at now, what brought her to the stage, and where she was when she first began this program. So, welcome everyone. Here's Cari. Cari, how are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah.
I'm doing awesome. So a quick little introduction. Could you explain to all of us your name, where you're from, and something that we might not know about you?
All right. My name is Cari Baker. I am from West Virginia, and I like to lift and exercise, and I'm just an overall very active person.
All right, nice. Cari, now, you've been through 10 weeks, and you're where you're at now. If you were to trace back 10 weeks, and to kind of give us a scope of where you were, how you were living, what made you wanna start this program?
Before this program started, before I came across your channel on YouTube, I lived in a lot of anger, a lot of guilt, a lot of shame, a lot of fear, and just overall unhappiness. What pulled me towards this program was that it had shown me a new approach that I had never heard of before. You know, everybody says that when you stutter that you have to do all these speech techniques and hide it and act like you aren't, you know, this person. And you just came across like as this very authentic, just pure person who portrayed himself to be just that. You know, like you didn't pretend, you didn't hide anything. And that helped me flip a switch in my head to say, hey, if he can, then I can too. So, yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome, Cari. That's really sick. Now, to dig a bit deeper into the state you're in that drove you to see this video on me on YouTube and to be in the position that said, that's it, let's reach out to him. How were you living? What was your day-to-day like that you wanted to get away from?
Just the unhappiness in myself. I would always look to other people. I would look to YouTube. I would look to everything external to give me some kind of answer that would just like, boom, like just solve all my problems and solve all my unhappiness. And I would be just, you know, this happy person that I was never, ever before. Yeah, it was just pure, like, unhappiness and just the amount of guilt and the shame that I've had from my past and my childhood and all that. Like, it was miserable. And I knew that there was some other way that I could approach this. I've let my stutter control me for 30 some years now, and I've let it control every aspect of my life, and I was just at the point where I got tired of it. It was constantly on my mind. No matter what I did or said, it was always there, like hanging on my freaking shoulder, you know? And I got tired of that stress and that unhappiness.
Yeah. I completely resonate with that. Let's fast forward a few weeks now, Cari, and let's say you're 2 weeks or 3 weeks into the program. What's something that has come up that you didn't expect would be there?
Well, as you know, it was about 3 weeks into the program, and I was making tremendous progress, and I felt great, and this is where I start crying. I had to make the choice to put my dog down. He was the love of my life for 15 years. And it destroyed every aspect of me. I didn't want to finish this program. I just wanted to sit in my house and cry. A part of me went with him when he passed. But as much as it hurt, I knew that it had to happen. He was teaching me something. He was saying that his life was over, that he taught me as much as he could, and that it was up to me from here on out. And ever since then, it's put everything in my life into a true perspective where I know that at any moment, something or someone that you love so much can be gone in the blink of an eye. And that everything in my life that I have had, that I've been stressed out about or mad or whatever, it's not that important. There's so much more important things in life to enjoy and to just live life and not have to stress about shit that you can't change, shit that's meant to happen. And I know that this was meant to happen, as painful as it is.
Thank you, Cari. Thank you for being so fucking vulnerable here. It's unreal to watch. It's unreal to watch. Now let's not really talk about the program right now, because I feel like you have something to share. Let's say someone else is watching this right now and they recently had something go wrong in their life like this. And they're down in the slumps. Like you were a few days after this happened, a few weeks. What allowed you to get out of this slump and continue this progression?
I made a promise to myself from the very, very beginning of this program that I would not quit on me ever again, no matter what happened. And when I had to say goodbye to my freaking best friend, everything in me told me to quit. But I knew that I couldn't. And for anybody out there hearing this right now, do not quit on you. You are more important than anything on this earth. Do not let anybody tell you that you can't do it. Don't let anybody fucking define you. Only you can define you. Plain and simple. Just do not quit on yourself. Throughout this whole program, I have been trying to mend that broken, non-existent relationship with that inner child within me, because I have shamed her, rejected her, not approved of her in any way, and have treated her like others have treated her. And that is why I am so unhappy. Well, I used to be unhappy. It's because I was rejecting everything about me to myself. And in order to overcome anything, you have to be able to accept that every part of you and embrace it. Even if you don't like it, it's a part of you. That's how you were created. And you have the power to change it. Only you.
It is definitely something that's said a lot, but it's the type of things that are said a lot have to be said a lot for that one time for it to click. Like, there's been so many times in my life that I hear something over and over and over and over again, but there's been one time I heard it and it clicked something. And I know that happened with someone out there. There's going to be hundreds of people that saw this. One of them would have had that click, and that's all I would like.
You just have to keep, you just have to take action. As you always say, take action. It's not how it ends up, it's just take action. And throughout this, it's like proving it to me, not other people, not you, not people really, but proving it to me has shifted my mind set to a completely different place as to how it used to be. I used to let shit fucking bother me so much. And now I'm able to embrace, you know, the outcome and not take it personal as much. I'm still trying to work on it. It's a process. This isn't like an overnight thing.
Yeah. All right. Now, Cari, if we're going down to, I know you just kind of talked about how your mindset has changed. If we were to talk more about who you are now versus who you were before, what has been the biggest change? What has been the biggest lever you have turned that has unlocked the most inside of you?
I am more conscious now. Throughout the breath work, the challenges that I've had to do, and just overall interactions with people, I now know how I operate. I now know how I process my anger and all that. It's like, it's really helped me become more present. I don't live in the past or freak out about the future as much anymore. It's helped train my brain over again. And just, I'm able to relax more. So yeah, like it's helped me become more conscious and just to be able to process any triggers more quickly and more effectively than prior to the program.
Yeah. And that's fucking massive. That's massive. As I told you before, I am someone who also needs a coach, and I had a mindset coach. And something complete, like when I first joined this program with the mindset coach, I was battling so many doubts. And when I graduated from the program, I was confident, I was carefree, I was killing it again. The thing that changed was I was conscious of when I had the negative thoughts. And I used to think it wouldn't be that big of a deal. But being able to see, oh, there's that thought, there's where it stemmed from, and there is just a hurt child. And seeing that and healing that is such, it's a mountainous life change. It was for me, and it was for you as well.
Right, yeah, and also it's, you want to be able to embrace the anxiousness, the fear. Like, you don't want to just push it out and say no to it. You know, this program has really taught me to accept it and not push it out and pretend that it's not there. Because the more you push it out, the more it comes right back at you. So the more you say, okay, I'm scared right now, okay, I'm angry right now, instead of pushing it out and saying no to it, you're saying, okay, come in, I'm going to play this out and, you know, see what happens, basically. And I noticed that I'm not as anxious anymore when I have to go talk or whatever. It's okay, I'm anxious right now, but I'm going to process it, and then I'm not sitting there in this anxious mess anymore. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Because also, that anxiousness and that anger and all that, that's also a part of you. So when you push it out and say no to it, you're just making it more pissed off at you, causing you more issues. So you want to say okay to it and embrace it.
100%. And that also leads you to the ability to learn from it. Because there's one thing to constantly feel anxiety, constantly feel anger, and you're like, fuck, I have to go to another day at work where I'm angry and I'm anxious and all of this stuff. But it's another thing when you're taking action and you're feeling anxious and you're feeling angry and you know where that's stemming from and you're aware. Now those situations are not problems. Those situations aren't, oh my God, this is gonna suck. It's, this is an opportunity to grow. I like I'm feeling anxiety and anger because now I will become a more developed, a more whole human being once I prove that I can do this task. Even when I am anxious, and even when I am anxious, I'm able to look and see and be aware of why I'm anxious, so I can actually grow from it.
Right. Yeah. Like, now I catch myself, kind of having that excitement when I'm challenging myself. Who cares what people say or what people fucking think? It's like, just fucking do it for you. Because you know how it helps you. So I look to the challenges now more than I have in the past, because I was so afraid of judgment and all that shit. And now it's just like, fuck you people, look at me, you know, look at what I can do, you know?
Yeah.
And to just know that if anyone passes any judgment on you, it's not about you, it's about them. And having that empathy towards them to say, well, I'm really sorry that you see me like this or that you judge me like that.
100%, Cari. That was something that was massive in my journey too, is understanding that concept. And it really sets you free. Now, last question, Cari, is let's say right now you have the opportunity to speak to yourself 1 year ago. You have the opportunity right now to speak to your old self that was 1 year ago, the Cari 1 year ago. What are you gonna tell her?
I would say so many things, but just mainly to be proud of who you are. Like, quit trying to change who you are for other people. Quit trying to quit trying to live up to other people's expectations of what they expect from you. This is about you. This is your life. You know, you need to live how you want to live without approval from others, because you need to approve of you first. When you're happy with who you are, then you can give other people happiness. But to just love and embrace that inner child within you, because he, because she, or he, you know, if you know anyone's out here freaking watching this, they need you more than anybody, you know. And for you to love them and give them the approval that they never had before will give you the approval that you've never had before. And it will make you so much happier, and you won't care as much. You will truly snap that chain in half that you've, you know, been hauling, like the chain attached to so much shit that you've carried in your life. Like, it just, it's crazy. Like, to imagine how I am today, last year, like, it would have never, I would have said, you're a liar, you're crazy, that's not possible.
That's fucking beautiful, Cari. You summed it up so well. You summed it up so well. It, I know I'm diluting what you said, but I still want to kind of add on. It's like, it has to start from you. There's no other way. There's no fucking other way. Happiness, whatever comes out that you want to have, it has to be inside of you first. That's the only way you'll ever experience it. And that's, it's completely true, completely massive. Too many people, I feel, try to get the approval and acceptance and happiness and joy and love from an external source that's completely out of their control. And when they don't have it inside of themselves, they cannot give it to anyone. So they're expecting something they're not giving anyone. And you only get what you give from other people. Exactly. And it's a never-ending loop of suffering. So.
Exactly. Yep.
Yeah, Cari. Thank you for hopping on this call. And thank you for everyone who watched. Just so you know, I want to give props to Cari right now. Cari, in 10 weeks, did not miss one morning of breath work. Unreal. Unreal. I don't know if any one of my clients were so accountable that they didn't miss one morning of breath work. I can say right now, none of my clients before this, in the dozens, I think 25 now, not one of them. You're the first one to have done that. That's amazing. I wish I could give you a trophy right now, but the trophy is in how you feel.
Absolutely. Yeah, for anyone out there, if you are in this program, don't miss the breath work. As much as it sucks, it changes your life.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. Well, thank you for hopping on, Cari. And I'll speak to all of you soon.